Right now we've got our fur blocked in pretty well, just placed it roughly in areas where we think we're going to put it. And now we're going to use the same principle as before. We're going to start applying or merging some of the vertices, matching the vertices into certain areas. So let's go ahead and begin. I am going to delete some layers, namely the ones we don't need anymore, and then we'll create some new layers to make things easy for us. Alright, first thing I want to get rid of or hide are the fur card planes. Let's go ahead and hide them. Might as well put that one in that layer there. Now let's just focus on the solid polyplanes or poly fur. As always, we begin with very simple, just moving all those vertices into the appropriate areas. I may need to hide these as well, so I'll put them on a second layer and just hide it. That way we can focus on getting good results with what we have here. So let's go ahead and just lock those vertices into their appropriate areas, like so. And remember, you want to make sure you're not messing around with the silhouette too much. So the silhouette is blocked in, but at the same time, you also don't want to adjust it. Okay, we're going to add some divisions. Let's go ahead and apply the vertex or vertices here. Very simple. Just trying to keep true to this. And I think it may be worth mentioning about things like Maya fur. Should we use stuff like that? And the answer is yes, you can. Remember, this is only one method that you can use to get this particular result. It's just one of the many methods. Let's go to the front view and double check our silhouette. It's not following that silhouette. That's totally okay. For now, all I really want to do is just try and maintain sort of the size, okay? I don't want to go too far out like that. I just want to kind of keep it around that area. Over here as well, I might just move it back ever so slightly. That's looking good. Let's go ahead and create a couple of new edge loops. So if you want to use stuff like Maya fur to create your fur, you can. And that's dependent upon the context of your project, okay? So if it's an animation project, then you certainly can use that. My style is somewhere in between, so like a nice little midpoint. That's looking good. I'm going to go ahead and merge the vertices to a point. So merge vertex, very easy. Adjust some of these other areas to give it a better curve. And that's looking great. So that one's done. Let's move on to the next one. This one should be fairly easy. We're going to lock it down here. And due to the size, I'm just thinking aloud to myself. I might keep it as just a simple sort of a four-face topology right there. Okay, lock the vertex like so. Same deal here. Hold V, middle mouse click onto that area. Now it's clipping a little bit. We're going to try and reduce that or minimize it as best as we can. That means we'll have to adjust some of the vertices down here, maybe move it up ever so slightly, and I may have it clip very lightly, but we'll see. Alright, next thing we'll do is let's add the vertices, the divisions here, so we can lock the faces appropriately. Same deal with the top, or the top direction. Yeah, but this one I might have to go all the way into the wireframe mode just to do that, and that's fine. Alrighty. Let's go ahead and insert edge loop tool, same deal with here. Because it is larger, we're adding just a few extra faces just to make it work. I might delete that first and fix just this face here. Same with this one. And maybe a bit of the top as well. Give it a very, very subtle curve. Very subtle arc. Oops. So 1, 2. And adjust the vertices. Like so. Then we'll merge vertex. Okay, just shrink it down, do some adjustments here and there. Sort of bring that face with that vertice down just so that we get a nicer feel or transition. Alright. Let's bring these two up, and now we can see where they sort of stand. So for this one, I'm going to hide that middle bit, or just blend it by locking it to those two vertices here. Same with this one. Same with this one. It's a bit hard to see because there's just so much happening in this wireframe. That's okay. Same with this one. Alright, great. Might do the same thing for the bottom just to get started anyway. Oops. Let's make sure we've got our clicking correct. And really all I'm doing is just selecting the areas that I think may give me the best deformation for the face. And over here, this is where we might have a bit of an issue because it's kind of going underneath. So I don't want it to go underneath. I'm going to move it one edge loop that direction. And just fix this one, like so. Okay. And let's double check our little silhouette here. Make sure we're on track, which we are, sort of. Let's go back to our perspective. So, or don't feel shy about going back and forth between these things. If you need to check something in a certain area, just switch, take a look, and make sure it's working okay for you. Okay, I don't even know why I rotated that, because I'm going to merge them anyway. Down here. And that's pretty good. Let's go add some edge loops. Down here as well, and of course the vertex. So merge vertex tool. Like so, just make sure it's working okay. Nice, looks good. Let's fix this one up here. Same deal as below, we're going to match the topology on this skull. And just move these bits into position. One thing you probably want to note is that any smoothing in between here may not be, isn't going to be necessary. It's only where it's going to be visible to the audience, okay? So inside, this is probably more relevant up here and the top of the head. Where usually we're pretty much going to just worry about the outside hair follicles first, or the hair strands. So just another thought to keep in mind as we go through this process. That's another one that we can work on. Great. Okay, looks good. Let's go ahead, clear off everything. I'm going to combine these because I'm going to commit to it. So combining it. Other side doesn't exist, which is fine. Just having one final check to, oh, I did miss something. So one right here and one in the back. Let me split the polygons. Make sure I catch that. That would have been embarrassing, would have been very weird. So let's fix that up. Like so. Okay. And over here, add two more divisions and we'll adjust to make it work. Very simple process. Nothing complicated about this segment, aside from the fact that you probably would want to just make sure that your head topology is right. Okay. So it's a good idea to go through this, the whole thing, and then worry about that a little bit later. All right, so that's done. Combined, inputs are clear. The transformations are frozen. We'll go ahead, select the head, and we'll go to merge edge. Just select the appropriate vertices. And now remember, I'm only worried about the outside, okay? So maybe back here as well. Just behind, and that's pretty good. And I can get rid of the stray vertices there. So I've only really selected all the outside vertices. And I'm hoping all the normals are pointing in the right direction. But let's just go ahead and see. Average normals, and voila, everything is now smoothed. Okay, none will be the wiser, as they would say. Let's turn on the rest of the fur. This one might be a bit messy. I'm going to delete the layer that we don't need anymore. I'm also going to just select the first layer and add it to a new layer here. So I'll be working on one thing at a time. All right, let's go back to wireframe unshaded. Yes, this is a long process, we know, but we'll get there. Patience, patience. All right, let's lock the vertices like so. And here, I'm just thinking, where can I put it? I can put it down in the middle here, so that will be a good starting point, and then over here. Okay, just right where we have it. And it's okay if we're overlapping this because the front one is going to be visible, okay? And then we can average the normals and everything will be okay. Now we have just a surface here. Let's go ahead and give it a slight arc. And because that's quite small and in a fairly not so obvious area, I might leave it at its current poly count, okay? So unbelievable. I'm just trying to select that. It's really hard. Okay, let's try that again. Merge vertex. Ugh, come on. There we go. Alright, that's great. Let's work on this one. I might turn on the other one just to see where we are, where we're at the moment. Okay, that's okay. So for this one, I might change it and place it over here, just right on the edge of that ear, and I'll delete this edge loop. Let's get rid of stray vertices. And then we'll appropriately resize it like so. So this will be one of the fur cards on the ear. So transition well. I'm thinking I can also duplicate it and maybe put it in here as well. Let's give that a try. Same deal. Just lock it to those specific vertices and adjust your mesh. That's not bad. It's looking pretty good. All right, next. Let's take a look and see where we can put this one. Might even move this one away slightly. But remember, I'm keeping notes, just a mental note of the silhouette. Because I am moving it around, it's going to break it a little bit. Okay, so let's just move it here first. And a few things we can do. We can split an edge on the head. Somewhere there, perhaps. This is where the creative decisions sort of come in. And you have to figure out what you want to do. Let's leave that for the moment, and what I will do is I will just average the normals on these vertices first. Okay. Great. Probably shouldn't have done that yet. I should have waited until I combined it. So that's just average and normals anyway. Yep, that's one of the issues. So combine. Let's check the toggle face. That's in reverse, so I'm going to switch it. Reverse. Okay. And just to repeat myself, to find out the face normals, just go to display, polygons, and then you have face normals somewhere. Face normals. Okay? So toggle face normal display, that's the same thing. Just the mouse script. Great. So I'm thinking we can delete these just temporarily so that I'm not getting confused. Okay, and let's go ahead and select those vertices. Like so. Of course, we have to manually deselect some of these areas. Okay, great. Again, double checking, going nice and slow, we're not rushing, and then we average the normals. And there we have it, we've got the fur coming out of the head quite nicely. Start on the bottom here. So down here we have the next few fur cards. Let's check out and see what we can do with this. I'm going to grab the base of it, and I'm thinking I can place it over here. Same over here, and one more just down there. I think it's a pretty good fit. Okay, good. Of course, I can shorten it to help just avoid blocking some of the solids there. I mean, we can add maybe one edge loop, which I think will be enough. Then place it like that. Just double check our topology. It's looking great. Then we'll move on to the merge vertex tool, and that's it. So that's another fur card done. Let's move on to the next one, which is this big one right here. And again, I want to double check my my silhouette. I'm thinking this one might be a little bit too low, so just moving it up slightly. Help us get that nice flow. Okay, so little things like that can help. Same deal here. This time I might just push it in like so. And remember, I also want to watch these, the silhouette of my character, so let's make sure I get my character looking sharp and readable. Okay, and we'll go ahead and create edge loops and just alter the general arc of that fur right there. I kind of like it when it sort of twists in this direction. So I might just exaggerate that a little bit. It might also, it will also help fill in that little gap there. Same deal here. Not too much, just a little bit. Okay, and then merge vertex. That one's done. Let's check to see if we've missed anything. I'm pretty sure we're pretty good. Let's go down and fix this one up. Going to enable this stuff here. Okay, so that's fine. I'm going to put this one, I'm going to make this one fairly large. This is another creative decision I'm making, is because I've got these small ones over here, and they all tend to be smaller than what's behind, okay? So I'll make this quite large just to help fill in those weird gaps. Great, create edge loop. Give it a very slight curve. Great. Again, being careful not to clip into anything else. So attention to detail is key here, which also means you have to slow down. Done. Check our silhouette, looking good. Might aim it or angle it up ever so slightly. Help with that flow. Oh dear, I don't want to go to paint effects. That's not what I want. Okay. Close those bits off. All right, and this one, this snazzy little one. Let's see where we can put it. Might be able to delete that for now. Let's just focus on this particular card. So now we're onto the main, or the front ones. Let's go ahead and, once again, just lock them into the vertices like so. Also, I want to give it a little bit of deformations over there. One thing I do want to explain what I'm doing here is I'm adding four. The reason being is because this ear is going to animate. So this particular card, and some of these as well, I might have to increase the number. I'm not sure yet, but it will need a little bit of extra resolution to help with that rigging, okay? So as always, it's just thinking ahead, keeping proactive in what we're trying to achieve, okay? So that's looking good. And I'm thinking I might be able to select the edges here, extrude it, and create an extra edge to go up in this direction. And this will help just transition between the side fur and then the top hair, okay? Of course, we can go ahead and just manually adjust these areas here. You can see even with this many polygons, it gets a bit harder to work with. I'm going to merge vertex, merge the vertices. Great. That's looking good. Smooth. We'll soften the edges. Looking great. Let's move on to this one. I'm just thinking where I can put this. I might just put it over here. Seems to be the most logical place to put this. So let's start with that. I'm going to do the end vertice there. Put that one over here. So this will be great to disguise that little corner over there. Okay. And depending on how you want to make this curve or work, I might push it just around towards the back, just closer to our faces over there. Alright. Get rid of those edges, and I just remembered you can delete them. I must have completely forgot. So less merging work. All right, let's shrink this down, adjust it. I think that's pretty good for the fur card in that area. Move to the next one, and this is where we need to sort of think again. We're getting very close to the eyes. And because we're using this technique, it's not going to be much of an issue, but you still need to take that into account. Okay, because sometimes it can cause issues, and we might encounter some when we get to the rigging stages. Let's just go ahead and wing it for the moment. Great. And then we'll push it in back on just to disguise that little corner over there as well. Might help. Great. Looking good. One issue up here is I feel that delineation is not that great for what we're trying to do. So I might just bring it down so that it curves out. Okay. Just to follow that path of the ear. More creative decisions as we go. Let's do the same over here as well. Might just push that one out. So that feels a bit better to me anyway. Your opinion may differ. So this fur card, same deal. Let's lock it over here in this direction. And we'll insert a new edge like that. And we should get some good readable results. Again, just following that flow as best as we can. Hopefully, we'll be able to get good results like this. All right, just delete the points. There we go. And let's just assess to see where we can put that one. I might move that one away just slightly. So for this one, I'm thinking it's okay. I think we can do without it. So let's go ahead and delete it. Not only is there not, there's limited places we can put it now. So at this stage, it's not going to matter too much. All right, for this one, again, just checking to see where I can place it. I'm gonna put it here. Might put it here as well. Oops, that's not what I wanted. Just want to get rid of the middle ones. Okay, and for this, I'm going to double check my flow, just the silhouette in general. That's pretty good. Work with that. Great. Umming and ahhing about this one. Not sure yet. Well, let's add this one and see what we can come up with. As always, keeping in mind that you still have full creative control. So we're really just tightening it up, seeing what we can get. This one can be a nice small fur card, so I'll make it tiny. Well, not too small. Just reasonably small. Like so, and then we'll push it here. Great. For these other fur cards, I'm thinking we can leave them out for the moment and add them in once we're confident that it will look good. But at this stage, I'm pretty happy with that. So let's go combine all the appropriate fur cards, including that one. Combine. Oops, I don't want to combine that one. Combine this. Great. Of course we can soften the edges. And go ahead and start averaging the normals. Okay, same deal. Select all the outside fur cards like that. Okay, and then we'll grab the inside here as well. I know we said that we don't need to on the interior parts, but because that's actually visible, it's best if we do so. Okay, so that one's got that one. Great. Let's go ahead and unselect everything that's not needed. Of course, we've got all the appropriate fur cards. Just double checking, make sure I've got everything that I need selected. And again, hoping that it's... No, it's reversed again. That's very frustrating. All right, let's go and reverse the normals. Reverse. Let's try that again. This is a very, very inefficient way to work, guys, but you can learn from my mistake. Okay, once again, selecting all the appropriate vertices. You can even save a mel script for those vertices when you select it, especially if you're testing certain things out and you have to go back to it every now and then. Great. And then of course we go to normals and average normals. There we go. Let's check out our fur card so far, and it's looking great. Got good read, it's a good transition, nothing's looking out of place, and we're pretty much ready to go to the next stage. Okay, see you in the next video.